I'm Ryan Betson.
I'm Dylan Button.
We are the Pop Cultures, and we are at the Nintendo booth for EB Expo 2017. Dude, you finally got to play Odyssey. What'd you think?
I did. It was awesome. It is like all the great things that make Mario awesome. The controls are smooth, you can now roll, you can triple jump, you can butt crunch, it's all the old school Mario-ing.
Butt crunch, is that the correct term?
I don't know, butt crunch sounds good, like, he's like this, and he's like exercising. But yeah, we played it on the Joy-Cons, but separate Joy-Cons, so you can get the motion controls. I would probably play with either a Pro Controller or just the Joy-Cons together. What did you think? You had a go of fun with the...
Yeah, so this is different to the levels that I played at the hands-on a couple of weeks back. So here we played on the New Donk City.
Yes.
And the Sand Kingdom.
I think it was. Orangey Sandy Kingdom. I can see it over there.
Yeah, so I played Donk City, but you played both, yeah?
I played both, yep. So the first one was more of a puzzling one, where it's like platforming and things like that. The Donk City is new to me, where you're like, you're talking to a lot of people. The thing was that, like, the mayor was trying to get the city all up in arms and happy and together, so you had to collect musicians. So you'd like go around and find these four
musicians.
Like
little collect quests.
Yeah, that's what it was more like. But then they had all the functionality in the Donk Land of the hat, where you can use the rocket. Did you use the rocket to shoot up to other areas? And then it kind of transformed into more platforming where you're swinging across.
Where you get to sort of see the with what Cappy, where they Cappy captures, not possesses, captures different items around the world. So you can become down like, you can shoot down like power lines and become people and drive RC cars and stuff. It was awesome.
I got on a scooter. Did you see the scooter?
No.
I was on a little scooter and then I could like jump and bounce off the taxis. That was pretty cool.
So like what I'm hearing here is we both played the same level, but we had very different outcomes and actions for what we did.
Yeah. I mean, it's depending on what the goals of the game are. It seems to be you collect these moon-shaped things to pass everything. So
yeah. So the moon shapes are fuel for your big ship.
Oh, okay. There you go. I didn't get the story intro or anything like that. But yeah, I used mostly like the old traditional Mario controls because that's what I'm used to, and then using the hat became a little like, okay, I got to get used to this. The good thing is for kids at least, you can like set the camera. So left is like to turn it left, right is to turn it. So you can always center the camera because sometimes you can get really lost in these games.
Yeah, like I don't know about you because it's not quite, it's a little finicky in terms of the camera. So like it's not quite as good as it should be. But yeah, the ability to just lock the camera back in one spot is really handy.
That's awesome. Will you be getting Mario Odyssey?
Yeah, I am. I'm loving my Switch, man. Like, so, you know what we've done this entire trip? We've played Nintendo Switch. We played Stardew Valley. I played Golf Story. It's all we've been doing. So if I can get more things on my Switch, hell yeah. That hat, I just realized, is really way too small for your head.
This is going to fill the void that Zelda left in my heart. Now, I think this will take solid, like, a couple of hours a day with the kids. It will probably be, like, my game for the next 2 months.
Speaking of Zelda, I think there are a lot of Zelda influences here in sort of the openness and what you can do. But anyway, this comes out really soon on October 27th this year.
This month?
That's like 2 weeks away. Three weeks away. What day is it? Anyway, I'm Ryan Betson.
The 8th. I'm Dylan Button, still.
We're the Pop Cultures, and this is the Nintendo booth for EB Expo 2017.
Yeah!